Now I'm just moving. This important. Okay, this is again an essay question in the topic. Okay, then I'll explain the process. What I'm trying to break my head is how to show the reactors with you. Okay, but otherwise the description is very easy. Okay, I'm telling the process. Okay, so what process I'm describing right now with you all is moving bed or fluid bed catalytic cracking. Okay, keep the heading and I shall explain stepwise. Okay, moving bed or fluid bed catalytic cracking. Okay, so I am describing you the process. Please bear with the diagram. Okay, but my understand my idea. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll take heavy oil. So the reactant is heavy oil. Heavy oil, okay, also called as feed oil or gas oil. That's the main reactant, okay. And again, I'll use the same old conditions, temperature 500 to around 530 degrees centigrade, pressure is 3 to 4 kilokgs per centimeter square. And the catalyst. Okay, if you write it here, you are given full marks. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll first take a heater. Okay, and that heater generates steam. Okay, and you using the steam, okay, what I'll do, I'll vaporize the heavy oil. Okay, this is vaporization of heavy oil. In this tower. Okay, I'll vaporize the heavy oil. Here the temperature is 500 to 530 degrees centigrade. Okay, I'll vaporize the heavy oil using the heater. At around 500 to 530 degrees centigrade. Then I'll pass the vapors into a tower containing, I'm talking the second tower. Okay. Cyclotron. Okay. So I'll pass the vapors into a tower. Containing catalyst. Okay, the catalyst is kept moving. Okay, this fine powder of catalyst is kept moving. Okay, what's the composition here? Catalyst, basically alumina, kisal guhar, clay, along with that zirconium, molybdenum, nickel, cobalt, various adsorbing materials are taken as catalyst and is kept rotating. Because it is a fine powder, it will appear these are vapors, this is fine powder. Okay, what is the temperature? 500 to 530 degrees centigrade. Okay, here a pressure of 3 to 5 almost nearly kgs per centimeter square pressure is applied. Okay, high temperatures and high pressures, what will happen on this catalytic bed? The vapors undergo cracking. Okay, after the vapors undergo cracking, what will happen? The vapors are using this cyclotron. Okay, it is a centrifugal. Ante ila tipputundi zarramanti irugutu untundannamata aa tippadam valana I want to make this powder rotate. So I am using this cyclotron to rotate under heavy pressure. Okay, em avutundi ee vapors vastunayi idi rotate avutundi. Rotate ayin tarvata idi suck chestundi, only gases ni suck chestundi. It will not allow any solid to come out of this chamber. Okay, what will happen over a period of time, this catalytic bed gets heavier because of deposition of carbon. What will happen, the solids that are not cracked remain here and only the vapors gush out of this centrifuging tower. Okay, and the everything in this tower are kept rotating with the help of a cyclotron. Okay, that is a centrifuger. What will happen after the vapors are sucked from the tower? What I'll do, I'll force those vapors to enter into a fractionating tower. Okay, I'll force those vapors to enter into a fractionating tower like this. Again, the fractionating tower is a long drawn tower. Okay, what it does, it does the fractional distillation, in which I will not take any other fraction except the petrol fraction. Okay, so I'll take the petrol fraction, which is C5 to C9, having a boiling range of 40 to 120 degrees centigrade. Okay, then I'll put this petrol in another small chamber called as stabilizer. Okay, what this stabilizer does, it will take away all the gases, any uncondensed gases by chance if they are present, this stabilizer will take away, and I'll get a very good quality petrol in this process. Okay, the type is called as moving bed catalytic cracking. Did you understand the concept? Okay, I shall repeat again. Okay, what I'll say, I want to do the cracking process using a catalyst which is kept rotating, and hence the name moving bed or fluid bed catalytic cracking. Okay, I'll generate steam in a heater. Okay, and I'll vaporize this heavy oil. This is also called as feed oil or gas oil. This vapors of the heavy oil are pumped into a tower. Okay, this tower contains catalyst maintained at a pressure of 3 to 5 kgs per centimeter square and temperature of 500 to 530 degrees centigrade. There is an instrument called as centrifuger, okay, or cyclotron, which keeps the contents in this chamber rotating. Okay, tapka taka taka tipputu untund anamata, so much so that the whole environment appears as if it is moving liquid or moving bed. Okay, like that it keeps rotating and there is cracking happening on this catalyst. Okay, what will happen by chance there is no cracking, it gets stuck onto this catalytic bed. Okay, and this comes down, and what will happen, only the vapors which underwent cracking are pushed to the top. Okay, because it is at very high pressure, it just sucks away the gases, and I'll suck those gases into a fractionating tower. Okay, fractionating tower, again fractional distillation. I'll take the petrol component and I'll put that petrol into a chamber called as stabilizer. It will cool so that all the petrol enters here as a liquid, and I will stabilize it. I'll see to it no other gases are present, only pure petrol is obtained. Okay, moving bed catalytic cracking. Okay, fine. Once they asked a question for 3 marks, what is catalytic cracking and what are the advantages of catalytic cracking? Okay, here the yields are around 80%. That's the efficiency of this catalytic cracking. Above 80% yields you will be getting. Okay, that's about the fluid bed catalytic cracking. So what are the advantages of catalytic cracking? First, temperatures are low. pressures are low, the time of cracking is less, the quality of petrol that is obtained is very good, and the yields are very, very high. These are the advantages of catalytic cracking. Okay, so I'll conclude this topic. Hope you all have understood. Sir, please, I'm sorry, the diagram is odd, but the contents are correct. Okay, so what do you say? Yeah, what are the advantages?
Low pressure, low temperatures, low pressures. First point, okay. Time of cracking is less.
Time of cracking is less. Okay. Good quality of petrol obtained. Good quality petrol obtained. Okay. Next. Yields are high. Yields are high. These are the advantages of catalytic cracking. Advantages of catalytic cracking. Hope you are able to see the board. I'm sorry. I think that ink is not very dark. Yeah, I'd leave you in another 10-15 minutes. By 11:45, I want to leave you all because you have been listening to the session right from the morning. Till this point, did you see the video? Chusaru kada ide mottam intavarku I have shown the videos. Sare, are the flow charts clear? Easy, fine. Moving bed catalytic cracking, mixed syllabus no. The next topic which I need to discuss with you all is about I'm not actually asking you all, because those who are present in the class, I know your engineering qualities, the way you have made the PPTs, the way you presented, and very good presentations, and lovely. Everything about the session was very good, but there is a batch in the class who have not submitted their PPTs. Actually, just like corrosion and all, what all topics that are there in this chemistry are very pictorial. Those have not done, they can do these videos, nice PPTs. You'll get very colorful and very presentable. You two of you have done, I think. Things. One is Rahman, the other one is Sumit, Kiran, and one other person has done the presentation on introduction to chemical fuels. Such a beautiful, pictorial, and colorful slides, which are informative, are being submitted. But those who have not done the presentations, you can just check. If you go, just type PPTs on. So and so topic, crude oil or petroleum or petrol, you'll be surprised to get very beautiful PPTs, and it could be a very pleasant presentation. If by chance, if you are new to making PPTs, no problem, you will learn it now. 10 slides you make and submit. This is what I want to tell those who have already done. If you ask those your friends who have already done this presentation or PPTs, they'll all help you out. Okay, because we are concluding the syllabus, probably you are really tired, but then my idea is to make you learn. That's the point. Those have already learned the art of making a presentation, like what you have done, you'll in no time you'll try to master the things, and you can make the slide presentations more technically down the lane that you have done a beginning. Okay, that's the point which I wanted to tell. Okay, after the small discussion, and then have to tell you all about the quality of petrol. very important thing. Okay, quality of petrol and diesel. Okay, quality of petrol and diesel. This is something which is very important. Okay. Okay, quality of petrol and diesel. Now, why I'm talking about this is because these are what we are using in our bikes, cars, and these two fluids or liquids are dictating the automobile industry. Very commercially useful. Enriching riches and ensured riches, that I'd say. Okay. So if I'm talking about the quality of diesel or petrol, okay, by this time you might have understood that the boiling range of petrol is 40 to 120 degrees centigrade. Whereas that of diesel is 250 to 320 degrees centigrade. Okay. That means this is a high, low boiling liquid and this is a high boiling liquid. Okay. The carbon contents are, C5 to C9. Okay. And here it is C10 to C18. Okay. The carbon contents. Now, it is a common known thing. What if the quality of petrol or diesel is not nice? Okay, which again depends upon the composition. There is knocking of the IC engines. Now, what are IC engines? Internal combustion engines. That means these are the places or the chambers in our bikes and cars which take the fuel. Okay, and the fuel, air, and liberate the heat energy or the energy required for running our bikes or cars. Okay, so the discussion. So what is the topic to be understood here? Okay, the quality of petrol depends upon the carbon content and the temperature range. Okay, and what is generally seen in the case of petrol is that if this petrol is containing hydrocarbons which are fast evaporating, that is having the carbon content less than 5 or less than that, having less boiling range and got associated with this petrol, the engine undergoes lot of crack noise, that is knocking will appear. In this case, what will happen? The ignition delay will take place. Okay. Here, ignition delay takes place, and here, fast ignition takes place. And hence is the discussion. Now, the quality of petrol can be improved by a process called as reforming, where they increase the branching, they increase the double bonds that are present in the components. Okay. Reforming is one process that is done to improve the quality of petrol. Okay. While improving the quality of petrol, what I will do? I will try to increase the branching of the molecules that are present rather than straight chain. I'll try to increase the double bonds or triple bonds that are present in the petrol, or what I'll see to it that it does not undergo fast ignition. Okay. That means I'll try to make this petrol ignite slowly. Slow burning, I will try to see here in this case. Whereas in the case of diesel, okay, it undergoes ignition delay. In the case of diesel, it is ignition delay that causes the problems with IC engines. Okay. So why the ignition delay? Because it is seen generally that this range from C10 to C18 carbons that are present if they are present in more branched state, more aromatic compounds are present, more double bonds are present rather than the straight chain compounds, what will happen? In this case, ignition delay occurs. Okay, here premature ignition, here ignition delay causes problems, and I will be doing a process called as a reforming process. Okay, and the reforming process increases the quality of petrol or diesel. Okay, not first much. ఇక్కడికి ఆపుతాం. రేపు ఆల్మోస్ట్ థియరీ పోర్షన్ అయిపోతాం ఫస్ట్ పీరియడ్. సరే, ఇక్కడ బాగా ఎక్కువసేపు విన్నారు. ఇప్పుడు ర్యాట్లింగ్ నాయిస్ వస్తూ ఉంటుంది ఎక్కడ, మీ బుర్రలో, పుట్టలో, అలాగా. ఎందుకు? అబ్బా, ఎంత సేపు క్లాస్ విన్నాను, అయ్యో బాబోయ్, 1.5 అవర్, మై గాడ్. దాంట్లో సగం టైం విన్నాను, సగం టైం వినలేదు, సగం టైం వింటూ ఏదేదో చేస్తున్నాను, సగం టైం ఏదో ఆలోచించేస్తున్నాను, బైక్ మీద వెళ్ళిపోయాను ఎక్కడికో. సరే సరే, ఈ పెట్రోల్ తీసుకున్నాను, డీజిల్ తీసుకున్నాను, ఫ్రాక్షనల్ డిస్టిలేషన్ చేశాను, క్రాకింగ్ చేశాను, ఇదంతా బాగుంది. అమ్మా, లెక్చర్స్ ఇన్ని విన్నాను, ఎంత లాస్ట్ కు వచ్చే పాయింట్ ఏంటంటే ఎంత అర్థమైందని కాదు, ఎంత అప్లికేటివ్ గా రాయగలిగాను. సరే, అదే పాయింట్ వచ్చింది ఇక్కడ. సరే, ఈ వచ్చిన పెట్రోల్ డీజిల్ ని నేను ఇంజిన్స్ లో పోసి వాడుతున్నా. అప్పుడు ఒక ప్రాపర్టీ తెలుసుకోవాలి, క్వాలిటీ. సరే, ఆ క్వాలిటీ ఏంటి పెట్రోల్ డీజిల్ కి? ఏంటంటే, పెట్రోల్ క్వాలిటీ సరిగ్గా లేదనుకో, ఏమవుతుంది? ప్రీమెచ్యూర్ ఇగ్నిషన్ అవుతుంది. అంటే 40 to 120 డిగ్రీస్ దాని బాయిలింగ్ రేంజ్ అయితే దాని ఇంకా తగ్గిపోయేది. దాని వలన ఏమవుతుంది, ఒకటేసారి నువ్వు కొంచెం హీట్ చేయడం మొదలు పెడితే గబ 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 కొంచెం బర్న్ అవ్వాల్సింది, గోల్డ్ బర్న్ అయిపోయి ఒకటేసారి హీట్ ఎనర్జీ చాలా వచ్చేసి అక్కడి నుంచి ఇంజిన్ వేడెక్కిపోయి చప్పుడు. అవే పాత సినిమాలు చూస్తే ఇంజిన్ వేడెక్కిందని నీళ్లు పోస్తూ ఉంటారు కార్లలో వాటిట్లో. ఒకడు మళ్ళా సాంగ్స్ కూడా మీ ఎంటర్టైన్మెంట్ కి, ఇప్పుడు అవి లేవు, అంత అవుట్డేటెడ్. ఓకే, అంటే ఏంటి, పెట్రోల్ విషయంలో ఫాస్ట్ ఇగ్నిషన్ అయ్యి చాలా హీట్ రిలీజ్ అయిపోయి అక్కడి నుంచి ఇంకా హీట్ మొత్తం యూటిలైజ్ అవ్వక ఇంజిన్ వేడెక్కిపోయి చాలా చప్పుడు చేసేస్తుంది, పూర్ క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్. అదే డీజిల్ కి వచ్చావనుకో, అది ఒక పట్టాన అసలు ఆనే అవ్వదు. అక్కడ తెలుసు, కార్స్ ఆన్ చేస్తూనే ఉంటారు, అదే అసలు వెళ్ళదు, ఇగ్నైట్ అవ్వదు. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఇగ్నిషన్ డిలే, ఇక్కడ ప్రీమెచ్యూర్ ఇగ్నిషన్, ఇక్కడ ఇగ్నిషన్ డిలే. ఎందుకు అంటే ఆ పూర్ క్వాలిటీ డీజిల్ ఉందనుకో, అదేమవుతుంది, అసలే హెవియర్ లిక్విడ్, దాంట్లో ఇంకా హెవియర్ ఫ్రాక్షన్స్ ఏమన్నా ఉన్నాయనుకో కాంపోజిషన్స్, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది, అది చచ్చిన బర్న్ అవ్వదు, అవక ఏమవుతుంది, ఆ ఇంజిన్ చప్పుడు చేయడం మొదలెడుతుంది. ఓకే, సో ఒకటి హై హీటింగ్ కి, ఒకటి వెరీ ఇన్ఎఫిషియంట్ హీటింగ్. ఓకే, సో క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ పర్టికులర్ గా డీజిల్ కూడా ఇంప్రూవ్ చేసే ప్రాసెస్ ని రిఫార్మింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ అంటాం. ఓకే, వాటిట్లో ఏం చేస్తారు, ఈ ఉన్న కాంపౌండ్స్ ఈ కార్బన్ రేంజ్ లో వాటి స్ట్రక్చరల్ చేంజెస్ చేసి ఆ క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ ని డీజిల్ ని ఇంక్రీస్ చేస్తారు. ఓకే, ఒకవేళ ఇంప్రూవ్ చేయకుండా అదే చెత్త క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ ఆర్ డీజిల్ ను వాడామనుకో, ఇట్ లీడ్స్ టు ఎ ర్యాట్లింగ్ సౌండ్, ఓకే, ఆఫ్ ద ఇంటర్నల్ కంబస్టన్ ఇంజిన్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ నాకింగ్. టుమారో ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అబౌట్ ద నాకింగ్ అండ్ హౌ పెట్రోల్ అండ్ డీజిల్ ఆర్ రేటెడ్, యాజ్ పెట్రోల్ ఇస్ రేటెడ్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆక్టేన్ రేటింగ్ అండ్ డీజిల్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ సెటేన్ రేటింగ్. వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ నో హౌ క్వశ్చన్ అడిగిన, ఎగ్జామ్ లో అడగకపోయినా అడుగుతారు, ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ అడుగుతారు, బట్ ఫర్ యువర్ నో హౌ ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఐ టేక్ ద అటెండెన్స్ అండ్ గుడ్. టుడే ఐ థింక్ యూ అండర్స్టూడ్ సంథింగ్ అబౌట్ ద ఫ్యూయల్ దట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఫర్ యువర్ బైక్స్ అండ్ కార్స్. ఓకే, లెట్ మీ టేక్ అటెండెన్స్.